Jacob draws marker on his face all the time. Or you can find a marker laying around. Just like, please somebody give me a tattoo on my face.
Me and Jedi, we have a very, very tight-knit relationship. We're always in competition at everything.
We have a big day ahead of us. Tonight we're playing the Grand Ole Opry right here in Nashville.
Tonight on the Opry, myself, Jasmine, Jedi, and Julie are going to dance. Me and Jasmine are going to beat Jedi and Julie once and for all.
So, the Jackson 5, they were a performing family. Their kids were insanely talented.
ABC, as easy as 1, 2, 3, as simple as do re mi. ABC, 1, 2, 3, baby, you and me, yeah.
Every family has a story.
A family is a lot of things.
We're dancers, artists, poets,
wrestlers.
People mostly know us from our band, the Willis Clan.
Yeah, gaze up at all without the
story. Yeah. And this one is ours.
You guys ready for a contest? Sit up, put your hands in your lap. Speak loudly and clearly. If you want me to hear you, you gotta speak louder than the other person. I will give you the card at the end and we'll see who has the most cards, okay?
I was an education major in college. And when I started student teaching, I realized that there were very few kids in my class that were right with the pace of the curriculum.
8, 8, 8, 9, 24, 20.
And I thought, you know what? I want to homeschool my kids so I can keep them at the right pace. If they're really smart, they breeze through it. We give them more challenging stuff. If it's hard for them, I want to be able to help them through that.
36, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40
kids all the way up to about middle school, and my dad takes over for high school. And we really try to fit it in whenever we can. We don't really get a spring break. We don't get snow days.
You have the numbers, but then you also have three different, they're called hands-on clock.
You know what? My younger kids, their education is completely different than my older kids. When Jester, Jenny, and Jet were little, that's all we did. We did school every day, all the time. I feel like the education that my little kids are getting is completely different. I have a schedule, and we do Bible at, 9 o'clock, and then we do math, and then we do reading, and then we do phonics, and then we do writing, and then we break for lunch, and then all of our music and our arts, and then, in the evening, it's projects. I feel like the younger kids are actually getting a better, more well-rounded education.
And the guy who painted this is Michelangelo, and he is super, 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 super famous.
Has read that name?
Michelangelo, right.
Last year.
Our parenting philosophy is so relaxed and natural. It's not structured and strict. From the time the babies were born and they were nursing, pretty much whenever they were hungry or tired or cried, I would nurse them pretty much just on demand. Anytime they needed it, they'd sleep with us, and they were just relaxed, happy babies. And we just sort of continue that into their childhood.
Salt and pepper. In our family, people wake up at different times, and some of them are like, I'm not that hungry, I'm not going to eat breakfast. Some of them are like, I'm really hungry, I have to have breakfast.
Oh,
my favorite breakfast is oatmeal. You know what my favorite breakfast is?
No.
Egg and sausage.
That's my favorite, too.
You say your favorite was oatmeal.
Well, that's my second favorite.
Family meetings are very important because when you're in a big family, there's so much stuff that needs to be done, and so you have to organize it to get everything done.
You don't need me. Do you need me anymore?
Baby, I need you for the rest of my life.
Oh, that's a nice thing to hear.
Do your parents flirt with each other a lot?
My parents are really affectionate with each other.
They're very funny and flirtish.
We use morning meetings or meetings anytime throughout the day to just kind of keep everybody on track.
Is Jager? There's Jager. Hey, good morning, Jager. Is Jada up yet? All right, big day. We got the Opry tonight.
The Grand Ole Opry is a radio program that's been going on for almost 90 years. Tonight we're going to play on the Grand Ole Opry, and we get to perform with Josh Turner. In the world of country music, Josh Turner is a huge star. We hear his songs on the radio all the time, and my kids are gigantic fans.
A couple years ago, Josh Turner was holding a dance competition, and me, Jasmine, Jedi, and Julie entered. Josh Turner and I think two other people were the judges, and they were up on stage.
And Julie and Jedi actually won the whole competition.
A little bummed about that, so I was really proud of that. That's the only time they ever beat me in Jasmine. Only time.
Tonight on the Grand Ole Opry, Jack and Jasmine and Jedi and Julie are going to get out there and dance. And it's going to be a bit of a rematch because they're going to be vying for the audience reaction. So, yeah, it'll definitely be a little bit of a contest out there.
Oh, Jager, I want you to get your... I don't want you to put the marker on your face anymore without permission, okay?
Jager draws a marker on his face all the time. But you can find a marker laying around. Just like, please somebody give me a tattoo on my face.
That's like whatever the thing is. I don't know.
Did you use a body marker or a regular permanent marker? Use a body marker, then it should come off.
We always use body marker.
We're playing the Opry tonight, and Josh Turner will look at you and go, what happened to that kid?
Tonight on the Opry, myself, Jasmine, Jedi, and Julie are going to dance, and me and Jasmine are going to beat Jedi and Julie once and for all. So we dance. It's very fun. It's hard, too. If a guy's good enough, he can dance with a girl who has no idea what she's doing and still get her through the motions and make her look good, basically.
Actually facing the audience. Are you comfortable talking about how your upbringing, no dancing?
Yeah.
Okay, why was that?
Well, I was raised in a really conservative Baptist environment. And, dancing was just one of those things that was very forbidden. But there is an appropriate way to dance. The Bible says there is a time to dance. And when I see my kids swing dancing, particularly Jer, who's amazing, I just think it's one of the most beautiful things I've ever seen. I wish that I could dance like that. They're very gracious to me and occasionally get me out on the dance floor. And they're nice to me, the boys are. But I just think it's a beautiful thing. And it makes me really happy to know that my boys know how to treat a young lady. I love that.
All right, guys, how's it coming?
My dad, a lot of times, when we're working on something, music or dance, he'll come down and really wants everything to be perfect.
Jedi, you're a little bit look like you're a cowboy. And Julie, you're a little bit...
My dad's not a dancer. But he's an artist. He sees, even though if he can't do it, he can see it and tell us.
Come get me and I'll watch one more time, and then you guys can move on to other stuff. Jada, your job is to be cute.
Well, that's a hard job, Jada, isn't it?
For you,
if that was my job, I wouldn't be able to get that.
Grocery shopping is not a big deal in our house. People think it's this huge ordeal.
Yeah, I love eating beans, but my family doesn't like it when I eat beans, you know?
So the Jackson 5, they were a performing family. Their kids were insanely talented. We get compared to the older family bands like the Partridge Family and the Osmonds and the Von Trapps, but we really don't get compared to anybody current. So the Jackson 5, they were a performing family. Their kids were insanely talented. So they see the songs and, they found the song ABC and started singing it and playing around with it. So, yeah, it's kind of fun that they can kind of make that connection back to another performing family years ago and then sing their song. So, yeah, it's kind of a fun thing for them to do.
Sit yourself down, take a seat. All you gotta do is repeat after me. ABC, as easy as 1, 2, 3. As simple as do re mi. ABC, 1, 2, 3, be you and me. ABC, as easy as 1, 2, 3. As simple as do re mi. ABC, 1, 2, 3, be you and me. Yeah, yeah. Be ready and repetitive. All the branches of learning tree. And without the roots of your love. Incomplete. Teacher's gonna
Because we're such a large family, a lot of times people think that everything has to be scheduled out. Either that or everything is just super chaotic.
And you just,
yes,
you just,
one, we're stereotyped that our house is always a mess. Just, it's insane. It's crazy. We never know what's going on. They think of their life, and they think of the workload they have, and they go, oh, my gosh, it must be so much. How do you deal with that? What's the special, amazing thing that happens when you do these normal things?
Strangers walk up to me all the time at the grocery store, at a restaurant, on tour, and they say things like, oh, my gosh, you must be a saint. How do you handle that? Or I'd be going crazy.
Can you read the list to me when we get inside?
I'm not a big shopper person. I would rather be doing things that really matter. I'm not really into shopping that much.
Get some cuties.
So I try to do it as little as possible.
Why don't you do this? I'll work over here.
She'll usually take like a big girl, and that way we can split the store. It's not like she wants to send a five-year-old out in the store by themselves.
We got broccoli, we got mushroom, celery. Ooh, I need more garlic. Get some red ones, that's fine.
Grocery shopping is not a big deal in our house. People think it's this huge ordeal that we have to go. Everyone has to go, and you have 10 carts full of food, and it's this huge ordeal, and it's a receipt a mile long and stuff.
Groceries can be on an easy day when I don't have to stock up, you know, like 600 and something a week. If I really have to stock up when I've been gone a while, it's closer to 1,000 a week that I have to spend on groceries. Heaven is a very unique project, I think, because we haven't told our kids, get in one genre and stay there.
So this new album is actually really cool. I'm really excited about it.
Done.
Of course, they wrote the songs for Heaven, and then Toby's been teaching them all the engineering so they can actually sit down and record themselves in the booth.
The lead vocal sounds dry. It's like the effects disappeared on her. It just sounds, all of a sudden, it's like she needs, it's like there's effects earlier in the song, and now all of a sudden she's drier.
Sometimes there'll just be hours of me, Jer, or Dad, or all of us, just kind of like sitting around a computer, and one person will go, did you hear that? And we're like, no. We go back and we listen, and we point some out, and everybody's like, oh my gosh, I can't believe I didn't hear that before. We gotta go and we gotta fix that.
You're not looking at the whole song. Look at the whole song. And look at
this
that.
One is going out mainstream. It's gonna be in, you know, online markets and physical markets all across America.
You can turn it up a dB or two.
It's just a step up from what we've ever done in the past. So I'm hoping that it goes really well and that people like it.
What are you doing?
I am making lunch for everyone.
What are you making?
I'm making taco salad.
We make taco salad quite a bit. It's one of the family's favorites.
Does taco salad have sort of all the nutritional sustenance that your kids need in one meal?
That's such a funny question. Yeah, I mean, I feel like every day at lunch we try to have raw vegetables and protein.
Make sure you don't cut them too big. Dad likes them smaller. It's definitely important for girls to be able to know how to run a household, and that involves cooking and kitchen work, because it's definitely something that we're going to have to do with our future families.
I do believe that there are gender roles that are just God-given, and you just can't. I mean, women were made to have babies. You just can't get away from that fact. You know, it's just the anatomy. That's just the way it is.
Hey, Jada, do you want to go tell Daddy it's time to eat?
All right. Who didn't chop up the lettuce small? One of my pet peeves.
He's learning, Daddy.
Jada, I need to take you to the mat and teach you a lesson, buddy.
Sometimes we're on the road, and we're eating out, and they're like, I just really want a taco salad. So I'll stop at the store, and I'll just pick up all the stuff and fix it right there in the bus. They love it.
Yeah, I love eating beans, but my family doesn't like it when I eat beans, you know? Makes you smart, right?
My favorite is taco salad. Taco salad.
Okay, Jager, do you want some cheese on the top or on the side?
So breakfast is one of those, it's very loose in our family. Lunch and dinner are way more structured. You know, lunch is served between 12 and 12:30. It's put out on the bar. Everyone is called. By and large, we do try to have lunch and dinner on time and a little bit more family time.
Tonight on the Opry, Jackson, Jasmine, Julie, and I are going to be dancing with Josh Turner. And it's a rematch, and I'm going to be defending my title as the winner.
Jedi put Julie into a tangle drop. And just totally split his pants.
We need
to be running a dance practice right now, and so, well, last night it rained a whole bunch, and so this floor is going to flood, so we had to move everything up on the little bit higher ground, and that's our dance floor, so now we're trying to get everything back so that we can practice dance.
The Willis basement, well, one half of the Willis basement is where we do our dance practice and our workouts. My dad, coming from a really big wrestling background, did a whole lot of working out in high school and college. So when he had his own sons, he wanted to provide them with really, really nice equipment for working out. And so he got really good gear, and it's equivalent to gear that you could go to a gym and pay for, but it's right here in our home. And very convenient, very nice.
So, all right, so let's go over the list of moves. Jasmine, I can do the cartwheel.
Tonight on the Opry, Jackson, Jasmine, Julie, and I are going to be dancing with Josh Turner. And it's a rematch, and I'm going to be defending my title as the winner. We're really not going to do the exact same thing. We're going to be on opposite ends of the stage. So we might do like a battle, almost where we're like trading off. Like, I do a big move, and then he tries to outdo me. So it's kind of like, who's better? Of course, I'm going to win, so.
Jedi put Julie into a tangle drop and just totally split his pants.
Ripped his pants?
Two times Jedi split his pants dancing, and one of them was on stage.
I don't know, he just keeps splitting his pants.
They're not too small, they're just, my butt's too big.
There you go.
We need to at least run over the bridge, too, because that's...
Okay, let's try singing the whole song.
Yeah, try singing the whole thing.
Ew.
Why not?
Not with morning voice.
It's almost noon. Why do you still have a morning voice?
My voice is on a musician schedule. It doesn't wake up till noon, and it stays awake till, like, 1 a.m.
What time is it?
Tonight, we're going to be playing on the Grand Ole Opry. We want to try a new song, but we're still trying to get all the parts worked out.
Do you want me to sing that or not?
Nope. That is my moment.
No, I mean, her.
Seriously, guys, you got to sing louder because I can't hear you do it.
Seems like just as long as
okay, you can now make that face when you sing that.
Working with your siblings teaches you how to get along with people.
Seems like just as long as I remember, I've never found a place on the fire.
Stop. Parents have always said you're gonna treat your wife how you treat your siblings. That can be scary sometimes.
Mommy, look how good my friend kicks are.
That's better. Oh my! I see the exposure that my little ones have to dance, and it is so much greater than what my big kids had. My big kids had a couple of videos, and that's all they ever saw. The little kids see it all the time. And I actually see Jager and Jada being better at their ages now than my big kids were at those ages.
How about if I go, one, two, three, kick? Well, let's point our toes, Jager. The big kids had lessons and struggled through things, and it was a lot harder for them.
I'm doing higher kicks, so it's hard to point your toes.
No, you always point your toes, even no matter how high it is.
Two, three, kick.
Little kids are doing great.
Can we try the song so we can test the vocals? And then people start getting ready.
The new song that we want to play tonight on the Opry isn't quite working, so we want to have Dad come in and give us the honest truth about it.
There are always creative differences in the band, in between my dad and the kids, in between the kids and themselves, in between mom and everybody has great ideas that they want to try.
Don't hold up the rest of the band. If I need to spend time afterwards, after the rest of the band is ready, that's fine. Let's not hold up the whole band and the girls getting ready because I can't figure something out.
We definitely have this open communication where he'll give some, we'll give some, and we work together.
This is a new song, and to be honest, it's not even close.
So what are we playing tonight?
City Down Below.
is what I would recommend. It's the same thing. I'd rather go with the one that you guys are good to go with rather than throwing the new thing before we're ready.
A lot of times Jessica's the one who writes the song, so even though Jared or I might have a different opinion on how we want to hear the song, ultimately it is a song that Jess wrote, so we kind of give her the last say.
Give them one more chance, but please. For I know they sinned against your just grief. But if they spit your righteous men, will you stop thinking? Would you spare that city down below? Down below, would you spare the wicked city down below?
Me and Jedi, we have a very, very tight-knit relationship. We're always in competition at everything.
I have never made the mistake of forgetting something that important.
When we found out that we were playing the same night as Josh Turner, we were like, why don't we go and dance with him like we did for the competition? We were so excited. We were like, we need to dance.
Games of Pit
To see the full music video, go to tlc.com/thewillisfamily.
Me and Jedi, we have a very, very tight-knit relationship because not only are we brothers and we're right next to each other in the lineup of our family, but we're also wrestling partners. We both started learning pretty much wrestling at the same time. We are always in competition at everything. But we're also in our band, we make up the rhythm section. And so bass and drums, that's a very, very important part of a band. And you kind of have to get along so that you can produce the music that you want. Ever since we've been very small, we've been kind of going head-to-head because we're right next to each other and we're wrestlers. So we definitely have our moments where we are very mad at each other, but we kind of have to get along because we're in a band, so it kind of forces us to get along. And
I get to beat up him all the time when we wrestle, so. Okay, so Jedi, a long time ago, was this really little, really
what?
Fast.
Really little.
Yes, you were little. Really fast kid that would annoy the heck out of everyone. Now, since I was just older than him, normally I was the one talking him into everything, but it was mainly Jared who would get, like, very annoyed at him. And it was always, you know, I would never get in trouble. It was always Jedi getting in trouble, but I would be the one telling him what to do.
That is so true. Jackson, I was always the one that got blamed for everything he did. Because we were like, he'd be like, oh, Jedi, let's do this. I'm like, no. And then he would actually talk me into doing it. And then I'd do it, and then they would go completely south. And I'd be like, boys, what are you doing? And Jackson's like, oh, Jedi. So.
We have a big day ahead of us. Tonight we're playing the Grand Ole Opry right here in Nashville. Obviously, we want them to look good on stage. And little kids can pick out any crazy thing and think that they'll look good on stage. Do you guys have your outfits picked out for tonight?
Yes.
Okay,
yes.
Show me what you got. Let me see if I can... So we have to have set outfits. So they have like 4 or 5 different approved stage outfits.
Shirt,
your jeans. You got an extra shirt just in case. I got that.
Yes.
How about you, Jada? Have we picked out your outfits yet?
Well, she's got a bunch of people.
It's good, but what about your little black one with the silver polka dots on it and your denim jacket? Might be a good idea. What do you think about that? Typically when we play the Opry, I give the kids a nap. Jager and Jada particularly need a nap because 9 o'clock at night, it's kind of late for them to be performing.
Do you think you need a nap? We're first tonight. We're not last.
I don't think you need a nap.
Yeah, I don't think you need a nap.
Are you tired?
No.
You don't want to take a nap? Yeah, we're going really early.
Because I laid down for a while.
You did lay down already for a while? Just all by yourself? You laid down for a while? Oh, did you sleep? You did? You went to sleep at... Well, you're a big girl giving yourself your Opry nap. That's cool.
I wish I can give myself a nap.
Oh, at night.
Oh, at night you lay down for a while. I see. Tonight, we're going to be performing with Josh Turner, but performing much earlier in the evening, more like 7 or 7:30. So I decided that I would give them the option whether they wanted a nap. And they both were real energetic and excited, so they're like, no, we don't need a nap. I don't think it'll be a problem. And then if you get tired, you can still take a little nap at the Opry if you need to.
Okay, guys, it's 1:30. Here you go.
Toby, I'm starting the van. Toby bought me this incredible hat for Christmas. Looks like some Russian thing.
The hat is very unusual.
I get the biggest kick out of putting it on and seeing the reactions of everyone in the house.
It looks so weird. It looks like this big furry animal on top of my head.
Of course, it was a gift from my husband, so I like it.
So we're in the Opry shop trying to find something that you can wear on stage in about 45 minutes.
I have never made the mistake of forgetting something that important. Jack and Jedi and Jasmine and Julie are going to have a rematch dance while Josh Turner sings. In the world of country music, the Grand Ole Opry is the iconic radio program.
I originally came from Chicago, never listened to country music, couldn't name you one country music artist. But when we moved to Nashville after about 5-10 years, all of a sudden, you know, you're meeting people in these bands and you're like, what? You know, and everybody looks at you like, you know, where have you lived? Mars? And so after a while you start listening and stuff, and so you start learning who the big people are.
We started playing the Opry regularly about a year and a half ago. The kids do bring a really great response from the crowd, and they really like that. And we even get called for last-minute things. I mean, that's how the Josh Turner thing worked out, is we weren't scheduled for that night, but someone canceled. And so they gave us a last-minute call and said, hey, can you play the Opry Tuesday? We had a cancellation. So that's really a neat opportunity for us.
Thank you. So I will...
Did Jess say she forgot her GoPro?
No. Outfit.
Oh, her outfit. Oh, jeez.
You just have to laugh. You just have to laugh because we're so busy all the time, and there's so many things that we have to remember that when somebody forgets something like an outfit, you just gotta laugh.
So you sure you forgot your outfit?
Yeah, it's still hanging up in my closet. I had it all ready on one hanger.
I mean, because they could have forgotten an instrument, or we could have forgotten a kid, but someone forgot an outfit. It's like, okay, you know what? We can handle that. We can go get, you know, another outfit somewhere, and I'm sure there's plenty of other performers here that have outfits that you could probably wear. And so something like that is not necessarily a disaster.
She'll be scrubbing toilets all week.
Toby, I'm going to take her to the Apple shop first, and let's see what's in there.
We got sound check right now, though, right?
Okay. Yeah, go ahead and do sound check.
All right, quickly, get sound check done and over with.
Test 1, 2, 1, 2.
We are coming in and testing all the levels right now, having sound check. So basically we all just plug in and we test the levels in the house and make sure that we can hear ourselves and that everything's mixed right.
The dobro is loud. We'll have to ask her if she's turned up or if we turned her up, because she seems to be way louder than normal.
Dad is our sound engineer when we go on the road, and he knows our band and our songs like nobody else. So even though there are top-notch sound engineers here, the two of them working together can give us the best sound possible.
So we're done?
Okay, we're good. All right.
All right.
Thank you.
We are going to go on stage at the Grand Ole Opry in less than an hour, and Jeanette forgot her costume for stage. There's always a lot going on, and I have never made the mistake of forgetting something that important.
So we're in the Apri shop trying to find something that she can wear on stage in about 45 minutes.
That's darling.
My boots are black. I can't.
Look at that. That's black. That goes with your boots.
I should just make her go on stage with something that's like not the right size. And she'll learn her lesson real quick.
Thank you for helping us. Jen, you know what?
Jen, do you want to come help me get into this? You have to put it in here.
Oh, yeah.
Come in, Jess. Come in, Jess.
It would make for a better story if I left my performance clothes on purpose just because I wanted to get a new outfit, but that is, unfortunately, that is not the truth.
In addition to playing the Opry, Josh Turner has asked some of the kids to dance. Wow. Josh Turner actually knows who we are.
Well, they've grown up a little since you saw them last. That was 5 years ago.
Bit. Yeah.
So.
Absolutely.
When we found out that we were playing the same night as Josh Turner, we were like, what a coincidence. This is awesome. Why don't we go and dance with him like we did for the competition?
Right. How old are you? 16? Five.
I'd love, for example, if our kids had that kind of success. And I'm really thankful for all those great artists who nail it like that. That's great.
Couple times where I got really close to the edge of that stage, so I was like, ooh, not gonna do that.
We divide the smaller kids into two sections. Three of them stay on one side of the stage, and three of them on the other side of the stage.
All right, dance, stay.
So tonight the kids are having a performance on the Grand Ole Opry, but something special tonight, Jack and Jedi and Jasmine and Julie are going to have a rematch dance while Josh Turner sings.
I tell you what, it's always a pleasure to be out here at the Opry. I guess back in 2009, 2010, somewhere along in there, I actually had a dance contest, and two of the winners, they're actually two of the Willis clan. Yeah, there we go. We got four of them, two on each side of me. So we're going to do kind of an encore of what happened back in 2010, a little Why Don't We Just Dance. Here we go.
Reaction. If one can do something and they get audience reaction, then the other one's like, they do something crazy to try to get the audience reaction. So in a sense, I can honestly say that Jack and Jenny are still incredibly competitive.
There was a couple times where I got really close to the edge of that stage, so I was like, ooh, not gonna do that.
I think the dance went really well.
We had an amazing time, and I did not spill our pants.
Usually I have a couple of my band guys dancing around on that song, so the Willises did way better than my band guys. They put them to shame.
So good. I was out front watching the last meeting. Come on, Jack. Yes. Oh, that is
awesome. Woo! Put a rug on the stage at the Grand Ole Opry. Why don't you, Josh Turner, with the help of the Willis Clan tonight?
When people come to the Opry, they're expecting to see all these country music stars. And the Opry really does a good job of, yes, keeping all those country stars in there, but they also introduce other styles of music, other bands, and, I mean, we're not a country band. We don't play country music.
Well, this creative group that has made its way to the stage is a family of 12 brothers and sisters. Would you welcome the talent of the Willis Clan?
So we do this song on the Opry frequently called the Plowin' Song. The big kids go out and play the band part of it. They sing the song.
What you gonna do when the moonlight's gone? And dewdrops settle on a farmer's lawn. Gonna stay right here and dance till dawn.
Towards the end of it, we divide the smaller kids into two sections. Three of them stay on one side of the stage, and three of them on the other side of the stage.
All right, dancing.
Playing in front of a crowd like the Opry, that's just fun, and that ties us into the Nashville scene, and so we're so thankful.
Tasty good. Dover sounded very nice.
We don't take our opportunities for granted. People come from all over the world to see the Grand Ole Opry, and now they've seen us. If the audience loves what we do, we get to do more of what we love, making music, making records, and entertaining people. And we wouldn't want it any other way.
Jer first met Mary about a year ago.
I honestly thought there wasn't guys out there that were as good as Jer is.
I really want to marry that girl.
He has a very important question to ask.
Dance is so great. It's teaching them the social skills, the appropriate way to interact with the opposite sex.
You still haven't, like, taught them everything. They're awesome, but they're getting into it. They're going to be great dancers.